market was taking care of those issues. But there are certain other areas where you see that if you don't regulate it, you don't really prescribe the standard. Regulation and prescription of standards are two different things. One is that if you prescribe the quality of such standards, that is not a heavy-handed basically. Basically say this is a quality standard. But ultimately, the job of the regulator is to strike a balance between the customers, quality of service expectations and also the industry, all the stakeholders interested in the balance. And therefore, wherever it is required in terms of quality of service, regulatory kind of environment, and this is what we call benchmarks. And of course, if there is a need to modify these benchmarks, that also needs to be done as and when the need arises. For example, today we had now the 4G is rolled out, and you have newer means of lockdowns in the 4G, you have the call mute lockdown, you have other problems also, so you need to incorporate that. But I certainly agree that the overall objective of the regulation should be a high-touch regulation. Not regulating where it is not necessary, and you must always do an impact analysis in terms of cost. Because what is the regulatory cost? You can prescribe a regulation for how much cost it will incur for the industry to comply with that. That also has to be kept in mind, and we should certainly have a very, And I must say that the industry in our country is mature. Therefore, there are many areas where the industry is weak. And I also agree that regulations always precedes the events. Regulation can't sort of forecast, you can't sort of figure out as to what is going to happen. So therefore, let the free flow of things be allowed to happen for some time. Only when you see that there is a problem or there is a chaos developing, then only then you should again go back to the first principles, which is what is the purpose of the thing? Every policy must have a purpose. Every policy also must have a context in which it is conceived. So with these two things in mind, let's look at the scenario here. Currently, we do not have a data protection privacy law. That law is mandated. And that law will basically set broad standards and broad parameters as to how data should be handled for ensuring privacy, security, ownership. As for the TRAI, because we also believe that this is an extremely important subject. We had actually carried out a consultation, as you may be aware, where we have dealt with the three issues, the data ownership, the data security, and data privacy. In telecom space, and we are also cognizant of the fact that there is a Justice Secretary Committee to frame the law. So when we gave the recommendations to Karuna, for the government of India, we actually issued from giving recommendations from some of the 5, 6, 4 principles, which are general principles, while we gave recommendations on certain specific issues of the telecom space. So what we think the way it should happen is that the data protection and privacy law that when it comes will certainly take care of the issues as to certainly divide data into various categories. There is a data. Now there will be some very, very sensitive personal data, some critical data, some data which is not really so important from a privacy perspective or something. So essentially, probably the policy will take into account this categorization of data. One size fits all will not probably work. And if there are issues, and if the policy provides a lever for individual sectoral regulators and sectoral departments to really take some specific calls related to their specific data requirements, then you know what should happen. That's my thought process, that we should rather not jump the gun and say that I prescribe rules for my sector ahead of